Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna play with that shit. I'm not gonna test that. Although, wait, what does it matter at that point? I can just go kill now, and now I got the thing. The thing. Alright, vote in the chat. Are we gonna do Vicky Amelia, or should we do the Chalice Dungeon?
Very well.
Damn, we're rocking here. Chalice, I was fearing that you would say that. Dungeon time. Alright. Alright, gotta do it then. Gotta do it. I don't even remember what boss, like, I got to. What boss was? It was the fuck. Oh, no, I remember. I remember. It's the Bloodborne Beast for the fourth time. First three times, one attempt. No problem. No problem. Fourth time in the Chalice Dungeon? Big problem. Big problem. Alright, we want some. Oh, that's. Yeah, we're gonna do Executioner. This is not a democracy, this is a dictatorship, but I'll still listen to my people. I'm pretty sure it's the Bloodstarved Beast, but I might be wrong. Yeah, whatever. Let's just do it, boys. Let's just do it. Yeah, I guess it's this one. Layer 3. Wait. Shouldn't it say layer 3 heart? Or doesn't it say that until you've beaten it? I guess it's the lamp. So it doesn't say it until you've beaten it. I'm so excited for Destiny tomorrow, dudes. Like, I really wanted to play more Destiny today, but I was like, ah, fuck. I need to not play. I'm gonna stream a lot the next couple of days. So that's hopefully gonna be fun. See, I remember I did actually so far. Well, it's a dictatorship where I ask what you want, and if I don't totally disagree with it, we'll do that. Alright. No one is following me. Should we do big sword or small sword? I think I'm gonna do big sword. I should have bought something more in case I died. Oh, it's this one. I have done Bloodstarved Beast. Okay, alright. That's fair. That's fair. The crazy reach. Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy. I don't like him. Oh, dude. Should we try to, like, counter him? Nope, we should not. I'll try again. Thank you. Alright, that was pretty good actually. Dude, don't do that. That's not fair. Dude! I see you. He's like a little kid that wants attention. Should have visceral attacked him there. Dude. No! I got greedy. Fuck me, dude. What? All right, this is a problem. What? Yeah, all right. Fuck it. I don't know whether to save up for Bloodborne or House Wolves. I don't know. Like, I think... By the way, welcome to the stream, Jamie. I think it it's really hard. Like, it matters a lot which kind of game you prefer, I guess. I'd say House of Wolves is cheaper. You know what kind of game Destiny is. Bloodborne will probably be cheaper over time. I would probably, if you're like Downey, I would probably go House of Wolves because that matters more playing when there's a lot of people, which there will be tomorrow and the next days. Bloodborne, it doesn't matter if you play it now or in a month, and then it might be cheaper. But it depends if you want like a single player experience like this or more multiplayer, I'd say. And now I should have used those for bullets. That was really dumb. So I don't have any of the Ah, dude. Now I'm running out of bullets. I need to go, like, kill a couple enemies. That sucks. Yeah, but he's very different than Pearl, because Pearl, like, if you dodge in under him, he doesn't do that much. And also, I wasn't good at it, but, like, if you hit his legs, he just falls down. Yeah, the Prison of Elders looks... Well, I think it depends on what level you play it on, but I expect the level 35 is going to be super hard. We're going to be level 34. But I recommend both Destiny and Bloodborne. For sure. I won't be surprised if that is my number 1 and 2 this year. I guess Destiny doesn't really count because it didn't come out this year. Give me some bullets. Yeah, I think that's a good way of thinking it, Jamie. You also like, I think it depends on how much you like Destiny. If you really are up for some Destiny stuff, I think this is a great time to play some Destiny. And you have, I really enjoyed being part of the whole Bloodborne thing when that came out. But I think whether you play that now or in a month doesn't really matter. I always get so greedy with this fucker. It's like one little thing away from killing him, and then I fuck up a little bit. Alright, I think we're gonna see how many bullets this is, and then we'll do that. If you're doubting a lot, you could also... I know it's gonna be fun to be part of it, you know, tomorrow and stuff, but you could wait till tomorrow and check it out when people are streaming it. I'll definitely be streaming. I know a lot of the big streamers are gonna do it. Cathalion, Broman, Triple Wreck, some of those guys, and you could check it out. If you love Destiny, I would don't go with Destiny. But you could wait till tomorrow and then see. But I would probably go Destiny. But Bloodborne is great. I'm really happy about this game. Where did she go? Over there.
Welcome.
That's not what I needed to do. I'm an idiot. So dumb, I'm buying bullets now. And then it's 12 bullets. God. Fuck it, dude. It's the way it has to be. How many of the... Anchors and Tower Gaming on YouTube? Alright. I should check that out then. I think Destiny with House of Wolves is... Like, from what I've seen so far, that's gonna be so fucking good. That's gonna be one of my favorite games of all time. But I will get back to Bloodborne, and the YouTube is still a bit behind, so there will keep going 2 videos up on YouTube every day, hopefully, if I can get the upload to work, and if it doesn't crash on me or anything, every day for a while. So if you haven't watched that and or want to go back and see some of those moments, that will still be there. So I don't need this. Yeah, I think, like, for me, this is beginning to get into... We'll see how it is, but this could get into 10 out of 10 territory for me. And I have probably, like... I have under 10 games, at least, that I would give a 10 out of 10. So... There's 3 every time, so that should work. I fuck up right away, of course. Dude, what the fuck? Alright, let's be smart about this though. Oh, it's like that now, is it? I fuck up again. Alright, it's all good. It's all good. Keep it positive. Dude, don't die. What? I'm playing so bad right now. Dude. This is where I'm fucking up, because I'm using all my fucking blood vials. If I could be a little bit faster with that, I could get a hit in and then dodge. I'm not playing this very good. Holy shit, dude. I'm gonna let you finish, but Battlefront is gonna be the best game of all time. I hope so. I hope so. I just haven't seen enough of that to think that. I would be very happy if that's the case. It's just, yeah, I don't want to judge that when I haven't really seen a lot, where it, like Destiny, I've played a lot, so I kind of know what I'm getting. Oh, this is such a bummer. I really need to go farming. Maybe I should just try to go beat Vicky Amelia. Otherwise, I need to go farming a bit, because I'm out of vials and I'm out of bullets. Maybe I should do the faster sword on this dude. I'm really excited for Battlefront. It is probably the game I'm most excited for. Alright, we need to go farming a bit. Here. I don't get these quotes now, dude. What the fuck is going on? I get the Kanye reference though. I don't know if I told you guys before, but I was actually at the MTV. He did it twice. There was twice where Kanye went up on stage and like crashed it. And I was at one of them, one of the MTV Awards, where he went up. I wasn't at the Taylor Swift one, but I was at the other one where some other, like, some dudes won some award, and Kanye went up drunk and grabbed the mic. It was fucking hilarious. And then when I had to leave the event, I walked in the wrong direction, so I actually ended up in the super VIP section. And like by mistake, and I walked around, I was like, what the fuck? And then like I was just trying to get my jacket, and then I showed the number, and the dude who was like giving out the jackets and that one was like, you're in the wrong place, dude. And then he gave me like a shirt. Like, I got a sweatshirt that you're only getting in that area. And then he's just like, yeah, yeah, just enjoy yourself for some shit, he said. And then I grabbed a sandwich and left. So I got, like, a special shirt from that event. That was so awesome. That was such a weird experience. Oh, them bullets. Like, I didn't even mean to sneak into that area. Dude, fuck you. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. I almost should go back and kill those fucking wolves, because they give a shit. Oh, fuck. Alright, hey buddy. Dude, like, can we just... I don't know, have you been on top of what the... Dude, like... He's on the struggle, this dude. So many bloodstone shards. Yeah, I think it was pretty hilarious. I was actually, you know, I'm not that cool in those situations. Well, I guess more now. I think I was like 16 or 18, or I probably was 20. I don't know. I wasn't that old, but so I didn't keep my cool. I was more like, I hope I don't get in trouble. I'm not one of those cool kids who sneak into shit on purpose. Dude, fuck you. Oh, I fucked it up. I fucked it up. Dude, you got issues. No, yeah, that's... No, it was before I joined the press or anything. I wasn't very old, as I said. It was... I think it's probably 10 years ago, so I was probably 20. Something like that. And it was actually, this sounds crazy. I don't know if it's as crazy if you don't, like, my friends would, they would find this, they find this super hilarious as well, because of the kind of person I am. I am not, I don't know, I've changed as well. I would not be the kind of guy you would see at, like, pop stars or whatever, all those. And, like, at one point I didn't, like, you know, I wouldn't go up and dance and shit like that. But the way to get in, I got in as, like, crowd. And you actually had to audition to get in to be audience for the event. And what you had to do, like, you waited in, like, it was actually here in Copenhagen. When the MTV Awards were here. And then you had to, like, there was a long line for the audition. You go to audition. And then you have to, like, you got in five at a time, and you had to stand, like, I guess, like, those shows. Stand five people next to each other, and then they were, like, no music or anything. They're just, like, 3, 2, 1, dance. And then you just had to dance. So they were making sure that people who got in this audience could dance so it looked good in the shots on the TV show. So I did that, and then they were, like, you're in, you're not, go home. And then that was it, and then you got, like, an email or some shit. When to show up and stuff like that. It's some of the weirdest stuff I've ever seen. It was so weird, but it was a fun experience. For some Swedish producer. Nah, dude. I was just there as an audience, and it was so weird. That was a bizarre experience for sure. Well, there's one of those things behind it, but I'm never gonna get that. awesome. Chop that hand in there. That should give a lot. The wolves still give more. That's crazy. But I need to buy both vials and bullets. Jesus. That was such a crazy experience, that MTV thing. Holy fuck. Yeah, it is. I think if that was like a hidden camera thing where you, like, or a doc that could have filmed that, I think that would have been hilarious. Also because I was so not the guy that wanted that. Like, I was so nervous to get caught, even though I had, like, it wasn't even on purpose or anything. So me walking around there, walking into the wrong place and shit like that, I'm sure that would be hilarious to watch. Fuck the firefuckers sneaking up here. Creeping up. Little fucker. I would give half my PS4 to see that. Yeah. I should write some of those stories down, or maybe like do them on a proper podcast or something, because I feel like I have a lot of those weird fucking experiences where I'm like, what the fuck happened? But maybe a lot of people do. Actually, probably a lot of people do, but that's some of that shit, dude. Alright, let's call it here. Otherwise, I'm just gonna feel like doing a level. Should we do Vika? I need like more health potions for that as well. Young, shy Nick sneaking into the MTV Awards. I also remember I was a big fan of Justin. And, was it? I don't even remember if it was Justin or Mads Mikkelsen. I know, it's like, why would you think? I remember I saw both Mads Mikkelsen and Justin Timberlake there. Justin Timberlake was hosting. And I don't remember which one of them. I know it's weird to not remember which one of them it is, because they don't look alike or anything. But one of them wouldn't high-five me. Like, one of them high-fived me, and the other one just looked at me and walked past me. And I got so pissed. I think it was Justin. A fucker. If I ever meet him, dude, I'm gonna have a talking to him. Let him know, like, that's not okay. You don't let another dude hang like that. I'm so fucked. There was a lot of celebrities there. I don't really saw anyone I don't know, fuck, dude. Fuck, that's a lot. I don't think I saw anyone like there's like backstage sort of thing. Let's do 4. But I mean, I was definitely like, fuck you, dude. Like, why are you doing that? But he probably was, like, doing something or, I don't know, something like that. So it probably wasn't, like, to be a bad person or anything. But it definitely pissed me off. What an experience, dude. That was so bizarre. That's why, like, as I said, I was, like, super shy and shit when I was younger. But you should definitely, like... If you are, like, it's totally cool to be that, but if you can, like, try to push past it sometimes. Like, don't fuck yourself over by pushing yourself too much, but do some of that stuff sometimes, because that is, like, you get some crazy fucking experiences that way. It was like 2 or 3 years before it was in Copenhagen. It was in Stockholm because I really wanted to go that year, but I couldn't. Or maybe it was even younger, like before that. I don't want to look that up. MTV Europe Music Awards. This is gonna be weird for people watching it on YouTube, but you know what? I need to check this out. Isn't there like a history of where it's been? Dude, I'm fucking old. So it was in the Globe in 2000. I remember that. And then it was way later in Copenhagen. It was in 2006, so it's 9 years ago. So I was 20. I was 14 when it was in Stockholm. So yeah, I should have been 20 that year, depending on when in the year it was, before or after my birthday. Should we go again? I'm not gonna waste this shit. You know what, I'm gonna have it on. I don't know, is that... It's probably not worth using anyway. But you know what, I am gonna put... Didn't I have Molotovs? There we go, I should have some Molotovs, like, for the last shit. Heals HP and temporarily boosts stamina recovery speed. I don't know if it's worth using that shit when I only have one. I think I was 5, yeah. Now that you mention that, you had to be 18, because you need to be able to sign, like, sort of a contract and an NDA and shit like that. So, that, like, it was okay to be filmed and that they had the rights to use you, like, your image and all that shit. So you had to be 18. If you weren't 18, like, you could say, that you could bring a guardian, but, yeah, you had to be 18. At least the one in Copenhagen. I don't know if you could, the other ones, but if that changed. Well, that's weird. I watched a lot of MTV at that point, but I guess maybe it's different now. I haven't watched MTV in, like, forever. They're still doing that. Although, like, I might... Oh! No. Yeah, I might... I could actually see myself going again if it was in Denmark again. Not that I ever watched that shit, but... It was such a weird, different experience that it could be fun. But I'm probably too old now. They would probably be like, old man, what are you doing? Dude, like, really? Are you chasing me all this way? Good. It's the same with a lot of competitions we had in Game Reactor, actually. If it's, like, traveling and stuff, then it wasn't our decision. Like, just for, like, traveling and doing stuff, you often need to be 18 to be, like, legally in charge of yourself. That's why. Alright. I am actually gonna put on... Let's do fire and then bolt. Just in case, we need the boost at the end. Yeah, Nick, you're old. I am old. I feel old. The weird thing is, sometimes I'm like, I'm 30, but I'm not 30 yet. I just feel like I'm 30 because it's so close. Not that I really mind. I don't really care. I don't really care. Yeah, let's do this. Let's party! I don't know if I should have brought my vials, but now we do it this way. Dude, you're just a bad person all around. You know? And I mean that. Oh, fuck you. I don't know what psychological thing I have with that, but I hate having those lying around. Four vials already, I haven't even fucking touched him. Why am I so bad in the beginning? Dude. This is so dumb. Like, I'm wasting so many vials right away. I'm down to 8 now. See ya, Kevin. Fuck, dude. I would really like to take this fucker out. But I don't know if I have it in me right now. I really want to get to the forest and all that stuff as well. Fuck it, let's do it again. Let's just kill this fucker. Oh, Coben left. I'm reading wrong. Kevin is still here. Kevin is the trooper. Alright. I think I'm just gonna do this run with, like, trying to... Dude, like, really? Really? Is this a thing? How the fuck did that chase me all the way down here? I need some water. Be right back. Might be a good thing actually to bring more vials because I waste so many. Dude, like. What the fuck? I feel like, honestly, I really want to beat him, but I feel like I should just not do him right now. I should just move on a little bit, and then it'll be a lot easier if I've leveled up a little bit more.